Subarachnoid haemorrhage involves acute bleeding into the subarachnoid space. This is located between the arachnoid membrane and the pia mater, which are two of the meninges, the protective layers that cover the brain and spinal cord. The space contains cerebrospinal fluid, a clear, colourless liquid that acts as a cushion protecting the brain and spinal cord from trauma. Acute bleeding into the subarachnoid space results in a thunderclap headache that peaks within minutes and has a duration greater than 1 hour. This is usually described as the worst headache a person has ever experienced, and may be accompanied by symptoms that include vomiting, sensitivity to light known as photophobia, and non-focal neurological signs like reduced level of consciousness. The primary cause of subarachnoid haemorrhage involves the rupture of intracranial aneurysms. Around 90% of aneurysms originate from the anterior circulation, whilst 10% emerge from the posterior cerebral circulation. Aneurysm rupture accounts for approximately 85% of cases, and the remaining 15% stem from causes like non-aneurysmal subarachnoid haemorrhage, where cerebral artery walls become weak and rupture. Arteriovenous malformations are abnormal connections between cerebral arteries and veins. These can become unstable and haemorrhage. Arterial dissections are produced by weaknesses in the cerebral artery walls, and these can lead to rupture. And finally, the use of anticoagulants may lead to subarachnoid haemorrhage. The most significant risk factors for subarachnoid haemorrhage are a history of hypertension and smoking. Additionally, a family history of subarachnoid haemorrhage and certain genetic conditions such as Marfan syndrome, Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, neurofibromatosis type 1, and the presence of polycystic kidney disease substantially elevate the risk of aneurysm formation. An urgent non-contrast CT head is the gold standard imaging modality for the diagnosis of subarachnoid haemorrhage. CT imaging is highly accurate and will diagnose 93% of cases if done in the first 24 hours. But CT will identify nearly 100% of cases if performed within 6 hours. So ideally, CT head should be performed within 6 hours of the onset of symptoms. Confirmation of subarachnoid haemorrhage is based on the detection of hyperdense blood in the basal cisterns and sylvian fissures. A CT scan performed after 6 hours is less sensitive, and if the scan is inconclusive, a lumbar puncture may be considered to check for xanthochromia. Xanthochromia is a yellow discoloration of the cerebrospinal fluid, which is caused by the breakdown of red blood cells to produce bilirubin. The bilirubin gives the cerebrospinal fluid a yellow appearance. However, this process of red blood cell lysis can take at least 12 hours after symptom onset to produce enough bilirubin to cause xanthochromia. During a lumbar puncture, a needle is inserted into the subarachnoid space at the L4-L5 interspace, a level just below the superior aspect of the iliac crest. Typically, 3 to 4 samples of cerebrospinal fluid are collected and labelled sequentially to ensure accurate diagnosis. Visual confirmation of xanthochromia is not reliable and can lead to false positives. Therefore, spectrophotometric analysis is the gold standard for confirming the presence of elevated bilirubin in the cerebrospinal fluid. Once subarachnoid haemorrhage is confirmed, patients should have CT angiography, a specialized CT scan where an iodine-based contrast is used to illuminate cerebral circulation. This is used to identify the causal pathology, define the anatomy, and plan the best option to secure aneurysm-related haemorrhages. All cases of subarachnoid haemorrhage should be discussed with neurosurgical teams as early intervention within 48 hours reduces the risk of re-bleeding and disability rates. There are various tools to determine the severity of subarachnoid hemorrhage, such as the Hunt and Hess grading scale, the World Federation Neurological Surgeons grading scale, and the modified Fisher grading scale. All of these can be used to predict outcomes. However, we should not use subarachnoid hemorrhage severity score in isolation to determine the suitability of any management option. Surgical options include endovascular coiling, where a catheter is passed into the cerebral circulation to the location of the bleeding aneurysm and a coil is inserted. This compacts the aneurysm and prevents further bleeding. Surgical clipping is another option. Here, a craniotomy is performed and the bleeding aneurysm is located and a surgical clip is attached to stop further bleeding. Medical interventions include nimodipine administration. This is a calcium channel blocker which helps to dilate cerebral arteries and aids in preventing secondary cerebral ischemia. Reversal of anticoagulation is important because this can prevent re-bleeding. For patients with hydrocephalus, which is raised intracranial pressure due to the subarachnoid bleeding, a ventriculostomy or lumbar drainage may be used to alleviate intracerebral pressures.